Hi, welcome everyone to the fourth part of the RSA video series. In this part, we'll look at how we can define section properties to the different elements within a structure. We'll start off by looking at how we can define different types of prismatic sections to the different elements within our structure. Robot comes with an inbuilt catalog of section databases from across the globe. We can choose the requisite section database that we refer to based on our region. So in this case, let's say we want to make use of the Australian section database. So we can set that as the default section database. We can then go to the geometry menu and to the section tool to define the section properties. Now this tool is also available through a shortcut within the shortcut bar. Once the section dialog opens up, it shows you all the preloaded section profiles within this particular project. In case you want to create a new section profile, we can go to the new section tool. Again, now you can define sections for different types of materials: steel, concrete, timber, aluminium, whichever type of element you want to use in your project. Also, you have different profiles of sections coming from the database. So you have I sections, channels, angles. And once you filter out a particular profile, it will only show you that specific type of section within the table. We can also create parametric sections, so welded I sections or welded tube sections, T sections. So you can just define the properties and it will generate the section for you. We also have tapered sections. So in case I want to create tapered I's or tapered T sections, so you can just define the taper parameters at the start and at the end. Likewise for all the compounded sections, so your back-to-back channels or box channels or star angle sections, you can just specify the section size or the section profile of the section, and again you can even specify the spacing between the sections. We also have some specialized sections, so in case I want an I section with an additional flange plate or a corrugated section, so you can define that kind of section as well. Finally, for all non-prismatic sections, in case we don't have a particular option available, we can just specify the section properties. So area of cross section, moment of inertia, shear area, and all those things we can directly define over there. Now that was for all the steel sections. For RCC sections, you can define the cross-sectional characteristics, so the depth and the width. So like for beams, it could be an I section, it could be a rectangular section, it could be a T section. Similarly, for columns, it could be circular, rectangular, T, L, different types of options are available. For timber, you can either make use of the standard sections coming from the catalog, or you can again define it as a parametric section. Once you've added the requisite section within the sections tool, you can then select the elements to which you want to assign that particular section property. Once you do that, it automatically gets associated to that element. And in case we want to just quickly validate which sections have been assigned to which members within our structure graphically, we can make use of this color by property tool, which indicates what particular profile has been associated with which element. So very quickly, we are able to ascertain whether everything was defined correctly or not. Now this was for standard sections. For non-standard section, there is also a tool which allows you to create your own section types. So if I am using a specific type which is not available out of the box in one of the catalogs, I can create that profile myself. So there are different tools available in section definition tool to create sections. So you can use polylines, circles, arcs, different drawing utilities to create the section. In this case, we are just trying to create a cold form channel section, so we can define the geometry parameters. So in case I want to define the fillet radius, or I want to define the thickness of the plate, so you can define all those properties. And once you complete the modeling of the section, you can then save the section to one of the existing databases. By default, all user created sections are saved to the user database. You can then give some unique identification to this particular section, so that when you try and load it up in your project, you are able to easily identify it. You can also associate a section type to it. Once the section is created, you see robot automatically does certain calculations and identifies the centroid and shear center and all the other requisite geometry points. We can also generate a detailed calculation note for the same. We can also do some basic modifications in case that is required for the sections. But in this case, let's just go back to our project and let's see how we can bring that new section within our project. So I'll just go to the new section tool and go to the user section database, and there we can see the new section CS142 that we had just created using the section definition. Then we can assign it to the requisite member within our model. There is another interesting method which is available, which also saves us a lot of time in terms of creating these complex sections. So in case I have an AutoCAD drawing of the section that I want to create, I can just simply import that CAD layout as a DXF within the robot environment, and robot automatically converts the drawing into a section. So you have this import DXF tool. So in this case, I've just taken an example of a simple box girder that we make use of in different types of bridges. You can define some basic parameters for conversion of information from DXF into the robot environment. So how do you want, in which particular plane you want the section to be generated. Now, in case there are multiple contours within the section, you can specify which contours are to be read as solid elements and which contours are to be read as openings. So like for me, in this case, I have those two boxes. I want to define them as openings. And once I'm done with that, I can ask robot to again generate the section properties for this section type. So once it's generated does the section analysis, it will give you the detailed calculations for the same. We can also do a quick stress analysis for that section. You can identify what's the neutral axis position. You can identify what is the maximum and minimum stress value. So all those things can also be quickly calculated using this utility available in robot. And again, we can then save it to the database and re-import it back within our project environment. So again, this illustrates how easy it is to create complex composite section profiles. So again, if you are doing some bridge projects or we are doing some tunnel projects, so even for those kind of profiles, you are able to create your own section types. One final thing that we'll discuss is for all the planar elements that we have within a project, how do we define the property for those elements. So the property that we define for planar objects is the thickness of the plate. So whether it's the slab, the wall, in case we are defining a mat, so we can define the thickness. Now it could be a uniform thickness, or you can define uniformly varying thickness. So there are multiple options that you can define. So it could be varying along a line, along an edge, or it could be varying along a plane. We also have orthotropic definition for your thickness. So in case you are doing some kind of waffle slab design, or you're doing some cladding or corrugated sheets, so you have different configurations available for even those type of elements. So you can just specify the properties. Again, it's all parametric, so you can define the parameters for the element and you can then add it to the list of elements. So in this case, let's say I want to define the thickness of one of the slabs in my model. So I can just quickly specify the thickness value. Once I click on add, it automatically gets added to the list. From the list, I can select the requisite property. So in our case, we want a 200 thick slab and I want to associate it to one of the elements or one of the slab elements within my project. So I can just simply quickly select the element by selecting the edge and then associate that property to the element. Again, there are different selection tools which are available which also simplify the process. We'll have a detailed discussion around it in the later part of the series. With that, we come to the end of this video. I hope to see you back very soon in the next part, in which we'll be focusing on how we can define different types of properties for the elements. Till then, thank you and have a great day.